So hi. I have to pretend I'm talking to someone. It's terrible. Hi, my name is Jodie Wu, and I am CEO and founder of Global Cycle Solutions, which is a social enterprise working to transform the bicycle into a vehicle of innovation.
It's really all about creating jobs. It's about creating jobs that are not dependent on some overarching power structure, not jobs to some giant foreign corporation that tries to completely change the way the country works, but jobs that allow people to just have the dignity of being able to go out and survive.
We were actually the only team from that class to actually be a finalist. I built this MIT 100K business team, but now I have to build a Tanzania team. This is like a company team. It's no longer like a project team where we're just making a document. The success of our company depends on this new team that I'm going to have to build in Tanzania. That was a really special experience just because it's taught by Amy Smith, and you just sort of see her passion when she lectures, and so you get really fired up and you're like, oh, I can't wait for January. I'm going to go to my developing country and I'm going to save the world. And then you go in January and you realize that you can't save the world in 3 weeks. My project that I decided to bring was the Bicimolino, which is a pedal-powered maize sheller and grinder. We brought a $200 device there, but then I realized that people don't even have the $2 a day to even try to afford it. It's almost like, why spend $200 for this machine that you're only going to use for a small part of the year? And that's when I was just like wondering and thinking, and then it's really funny because the story is like I was like laying down and sleeping and then not being able to sleep because I'm jet lagged, and then I had this idea. So I like got out of bed, wrote down like, I'm gonna do this project. We're gonna try to figure out how to put this on a bicycle.
Jodie then went here for a whole summer in Tanzania and actually built several versions of this corn sheller that's attached to a bicycle that allows a person to bike to where the corn needs to be shelled and then use the power of the bike to bike in place and actually shell the corn.
Jodie came to Tanzania. She brought the idea of making a sheller, something, a device that you can put in a bicycle. And I joined her. Tools like I made these tools from bicycles also.
He seemed like a man of little words, but he's actually a very, very clever and funny man. And I mean, incredibly creative. He'll look around him and he can make anything out of anything.
So I used to make the furniture from bicycles, different kind of machine like water pumps, windmills, water heaters, something we call it press drill machine, like this one here. Similar to this, but mine is pedal power.
And that was my favorite moment on the trip, was seeing all the innovation and realizing like there's hope in the developing world, like there's talent in Tanzania, and it doesn't have to come from us. Taking the D-Lab sequence of classes, I found myself in development ventures and found myself pitching the idea of like this business around this bicycle attachment.
We both took a class called Development Ventures. It's about entrepreneurship, but for things aimed at the developing world. So we started there and we learned how to write executive summaries, give business pitches, and write business plans. And we recruited a team.
I had Lisa, And then Carolyn joined just as sort of part of the class. She was just really interested in it.
When I first joined them, like, they didn't feel like they had any, they weren't like, oh, this is my project that you're joining.
I went to the class trying to recruit MBAs and people who had different background from me, and then I got two mechanical engineers who were younger than me.
This was one of the best teams I've been a part of, and I still say that today, just because there's something magical about it.
So Alex joined us, and then I was like, yes, at least now we have a half engineer and half business. He was half engineering, half business. So I was like, okay, we're getting closer to getting the business aspect in. And then we found Javier, which was a dream come true. And he still is that same figure for me. He's still helping me along the way.
12 kilometers away, Bernard?
So I was introduced to Bernard. I guess you can say that was like where the momentum just sort of started. So that's how the team came to be. And then Semyon sort of came into the picture.
Well, I've been an entrepreneur for a number of years and had some successes. And for the last year or so, I've been looking around pretty hard to find something to do that's more meaningful. And then I guess I let word be known around MIT that I'm searching for the next opportunity. And Jos Bonson put me in touch with Lisa and Jodie.
So it was really, really fun to bring him on board because we're like, oh, he's an MIT blackjack guy. And so, but it was also great to have someone who had that entrepreneurial experience.
One technology in Guatemala can inspire a person in Africa, and then he builds a ton of technologies for his community. So this transfer of technology is amazing too.
It's a technology that could be maintained locally. It's not some foreign, expensive machine that will work like magic until it breaks and then that's it. This is something that's made out of bike parts. There are bike shops all over this country. Bicycles are used for transportation here, much more than cars. So it's something that people immediately understand. It makes sense. It's just one of these good ideas that makes sense for the local people.
But now we can have somebody like a residence making something for the people. So for me, I feel very proud of that.
You know, coming up with the technology itself is not really the hard part, but getting this technology into the hands of the people who need it, like that's where the real rocket science is.
It's just, it's the assumptions, basically, getting past the assumptions. And just being open to different ways of approaching business as well. There's not a formula for Africa, there's not a formula for Middle East, there's every single person, every single place has its own cultural identity, and every single village has its cultural identity.
Development is not easy, that's why there's no solution to it yet. I think people are still learning, and there's a lot of there's a lot of social aspects people forget when they're trying to disseminate a technology or start a company.
But essentially, he's in, and he was like
communication is very vital in a business, but it's so difficult. Every time we hold a meeting in the United States, we have to phone Jodie in. It takes us 15 to 30 minutes, no matter how prepared we are with conference numbers, and she has landlines. It's always a hit or miss.
And the hardware was off the wheel, so I couldn't roll a bike even. I couldn't find any hardware. It was like a little nuts. Oh, and did I mention I had to wear a suit? So there's nothing more fun than moving bicycles in suits.
The reason that I actually started the business in the first place was sort of wanting to find a way to give back to the community without actually asking for donations at any point, like actually having a self-sustaining way to give back.
It could have been structured as a nonprofit, but Jodie in particular really wanted to have it be a sustainable organization, and she thought one that makes a modest amount of profits and is in some sense more sustainable and a little maybe more honest than one that has to rely continuously on getting grants and donations.
I don't know anything about business, but I know how to create stuff. So my work will be to create ideas and maybe show them and introduce to them and see how they feel about those ideas.
I had the idea of a cell phone charger. If you want to charge,
you just put in the bicycle, but if you don't want to charge, you just take it out and keep it somewhere.
My dream is that GCS is spread. It's a big name, and it's inspired thousands of people. So maybe that'll take 10 years. I don't know.
I guess you can say it's almost like going full circle. Like the innovation is coming from the locals. We're bringing it to market, it's profiting, and then we're having more programs for the locals to go back to it to spur even more innovation. So it's like self-propelling itself forward.